friends. Welcome back to the channel, Basswood Carving. Today we're going to do a little video on how to carve a cowboy boot, but I wanted to show you what I had going on here. And so I was interested in like really getting better at carving my cowboy boots, my little cowboy boots on my caricatures. So another thing is I wanted to try a couple things. First, I wanted to actually carve the boot, the small boots, and I also wanted to test out some different paint styles to see what what paints I liked and what kind of different details I could put on the cowboy boots when I'm carving my caricatures. So in this video today, we're going to talk about that, and I added a little bit of wood burning to the caricature boots too. So we'll talk a little bit about that. I'll show you how I carve a quick cowboy boot, and this is how I applied my practice skills basically and created this little scene. So stay tuned and we'll get started on this video right away. Okay, so we're gonna get started. Let me explain a couple things to you. Like I said in the intro part of the video, I carved these little boots and I didn't glue them down yet because I wanted to use them for kind of the video, so I'll glue them all down, but you've seen what I did with them. So the purpose was to get better at carving these little boots, and also just carving boots, period. So what I did was I took a pattern, and I'll put a link to the pattern. It was the Woodcarver's Cabin pattern, and I give him all credits because he had that up there, and it's kind of where I found it. But what I did was I took the pattern and reduced it down to three different sizes. So I've got a big boot, a medium-sized boot here, and then the little boot, okay? And these are what I used to practice all these different boots. So I've got a boot here that the first one I did, and I was like, what can I do with this thing besides just have a boot? And I made a toothpick holder out of it. So my wife likes all the country western stuff, and so I thought, well, I could take this and make a toothpick holder out of it. So, you know, that's one thing you could do with it. You could carve a pair of them, have a right and a left, put them on a little mount and make a little figure out of them, maybe put a cowboy hat on them, you know, whatever you want to do with them. But my sole purpose was just practice, you know, because practice is how you get better in wood carving. And how better to practice than start off with something bigger, do your detail work and stuff on something bigger, and then condense that down to a smaller version of it. The other thing was, like I said in the intro, is I wanted to test some paints, different colors and stain paints, to make them, you know, see what I liked the best. At the same time, I was also experimenting with woodworking, or woodburning, I'm sorry, woodburning. So I wanted to see what the woodburning, the details in the shadows would make it look like, and also it made it easier to paint these little trims. I didn't have to really paint them. I could paint the whole thing and then go back with the woodburning tool and burn them in, and it really kind of gave it a little more shadow detail and things like that. And on this particular one, you'll see I even put the little stitch marks in there. So I'll show you how to do all these things. I probably won't sit here and carve a whole boot. That's why I kind of pre-did this one, so I could talk to you about how you do your details and stuff. So, you know, let's get started, and we'll get into carving some boots. So, like I said, it's all about practice. In order to get better, you just got to practice. That's all there is to it. So, you know, whether it's a big piece or a little piece, you know, you're still going to apply the same techniques, just little smaller strokes with your knife, pretty much. So, you know, the first thing you're going to do is, obviously, on mine, I took a Forstner bit and drilled a hole down in there so I could get all this out a little easier and faster. You can carve this from a square block if you don't have a bandsaw or a scroll saw to cut them out. I'll actually have a little video on bandsaws coming up. So if you're thinking about getting one or want to know some details, some things that I've learned from my bandsaw. So, You know, cut out your patterns or carve them out. These little ones you could carve just straight out of a block of wood. It was just better for me to lay a bunch of them out on a block of wood and then go back and cut them all out. And that gave me a lot of little practice tools. So, you know, whether, like I said, whether it's a big one or a little one, you know, you do the same things. Now, on the little ones, I didn't drive a big Forstner bit through there. I just cut the tabs out, left the tabs on the boots, drilled a little hole, then a bigger hole, then a bigger hole, and I just kind of wallered it out in there a little bit. And, you know, just be careful if you do that, that you don't drill through the back of your boot. I almost did that on one of them. So, let's get started. First thing you want to do is lay out your boot. Decide if you want a right or a left. And there's another option that you can play with is, you know, having a right and a left boot, but also you can have the curve of the boot. Like some boots don't have much curve to them at all. If you can see that, I don't know if you can tell in the video, but this is a left foot. So it's got that arch on the inside right here. This one just happens to be a left boot too, but it's also got a wider toe and it's got a little more curve right there. If you look at the smaller boot I did, this one's a woman's boot, so it's kind of skinny and got the little smaller pointed toe on it. So you can do pointed toes, square toes, you know, there's different kinds of boots. And, you know, I think it just gives you something to practice with and play around with and get variety, learn how to do some variety with your carvings. So, like I said, first thing we want to do, let's see, since that's a left boot, we'll make this one a right boot. So if it was sitting here going on my foot, the arch is going to be on this side right here. So turn it upside down. I put a little mark there that lets me know. And then start off, just put your little bit of an arch there. Now I know in the woodcarver's cabin pattern, he's got the arch already built in there for you. But sometimes it's good to just practice, you know, because I could have a skinny heel or a wide heel. So it just lets you play around with different options. Decide whether you want a pointed boot. If I want a pointed boot, I'm going to bring my boot probably a little more narrow and then probably less wide right here. So, but those are all things you can accomplish as you start carving down the boot. But just go ahead and start off with a little bit of an arch on the right side or the left side, whatever you decide to do. If you want to just carve one sort of like a toothpick holder and you want it to be a straight boot, you know, make it a straight boot, but just put just a little bit of arch, just enough that you know that it's a boot and it has an arch in it. And then that way it won't look as funny unless you want one boot on your table with toothpicks in it. So first thing we're going to do is just go down here and start taking off these corners. Now on the boot pattern, you're working with two opposite grains. So one's going this way right up here, and then right down here where the grains meet, you have two grains meeting going in opposite directions. So, you know, just be aware of that. It's going to, and I'll show you a little way that you can fix that. So mostly we're just going to be shaping this thing out, rounding it out, going around the boot, and taking off all the hard corners. And remember, when you're at one end of it, you're going to get that chunking. So be careful of your grain direction, okay? Because you don't want to chuck off, especially that little tab when you get down to it. Sometimes when you got direction and you're going off like that, it's a good practice. You can turn your block kind of sideways, and instead of cutting straight into it, just cut across it right here. And that way you'll have a little less chunking, especially when you get on these small boots, because they'll chunk on you. And, you know, that way you'll not lose a vital little piece, okay? So I'm going to take this down just a little bit, but then we're going to move on to the boot I've already got spent some time on. So basically, like I said, just go around, take all this down,
and get kind of the shape that you want. Some boots are wide, some boots are narrow. You know, it just decides on your preference. If I'm doing my cowboys, I want my cowboys to all have different boots. I don't want to do all the same boot on my cowboy. At least as far as paint style and detail and things like that. So that's what's cool about the little boots. They're inexpensive to cut out a bunch of them out of a piece of wood, and they're just fun. I really kind of had a lot of fun. You wouldn't think carving so many boots would be fun, but you know, just give me something that I could mindlessly work on, you know, while I was watching the TV or watching, you know, something else or listening to music or whatever. So point is practice. That's what any wood carver will tell you when you get started, is just practice and learn how to control your knife, learn how to work your tools, you know. All right, so we're just going to keep working this all the way around, taking off all your hard edges and get it down. Okay, you'll notice there's a little bit of a hump back here. Most boots have a curve going in, and I think when you really highlight that really makes it stand out. Like this one here, you can kind of see it's got a little curve in going on it. And some of them are longer boot. It's this one I left a little longer. It's still got the curve in there. It's got a little bit of a curve down in here. Okay, just make it, you know, make it look natural. Make it look like a real boot, but a funny looking boot. Okay. So I'm gonna grab a bigger knife. And chuck some more of this off. Just using pull cuts and push cuts. That's all I'm using. Okay, again, watch your grain. Gonna be going a couple different directions on you here, especially when you're in this curve right here. Just take and roll it up, and if it starts chunking off, turn it around the other way. And if you're working on a big boot, you know, you got a bunch of wood still to cut out, so, you know, chuck away on it. And when you get to the bottom, to start shaping it, start on the outside part of your boot. Like, so this is a right boot. Okay, when I turn it over, this is where my tip's going to be. So I'm going to start working that wood off on this side of it. I want to start getting that little curved in look. Okay, and you can do that by just rolling your knife. Once you get down to where you're almost, you know, ready to start finishing it up on the side, just you can start rolling in and roll your knife in and roll it out, and that'll kind of give you that little arched look. Okay, so again, I want to thank everybody that's subscribing to the channel. I really appreciate the comments and the emails I'm getting from everybody. You know, it's really cool. I didn't really start this out to be a teaching channel, a tutorial channel. It's more to highlight, you know, my time in carving and where I came from, so I can look back on these videos and probably about a couple years, if I carve a boot, it'll probably be 10 times better. But really, that was my purpose, and my purpose was to create a channel that everybody could learn from, not necessarily all my carving, but I'm involved in a pretty fun little carving club, and there's a lot of talented carvers. And when I first started this channel, you know, I had a partner that was going to be involved with me, so you'll be finding out more about him here shortly. He's getting ready to come on, so that's why I didn't really name it after my own personal name. I wanted it to be about carving, and I wanted to bring on other carvers, especially from my club and some of my friends that I've met while that that since I've been in the journey of carving. So it's really kind of document my carving journey. You're going to get to meet somebody here soon that's going to be coming on doing videos with me. And I'll introduce him and we'll meet him when the time comes, which should be in the next week or two, a couple weeks, I think. Just keep carving away. Get your shape that you want. And I'm not going to sit here and let you watch me carve a whole boot. You don't need to do that, you know, especially if you've been carving already. I'm sure, you know, you can go ahead and do your own boot. But just main thing is take off all your hard edges and think about where your arch is going to be. That's the two important things. Do you want a tipped up toe? Do you want a flat toe? That's why on this pattern, there's two different ledges here. Okay, so I can actually, if I want a lower boot sitting lower, then I can cut this tip off up here, roll it into this tip, and now I've got a lower boot. And if I want a curved up tip, which is most common on your caricatures, then I can cut this down and make it more of a curved up boot, which is what we did on this one. Okay, so go ahead and work on that one and get it down, get it to the size, get all your flat edges off, and we'll come back and talk about some of the other little details of doing the boot. Because getting the boot down is kind of the easy part, and putting the details in it, being creative with your details, is the fun part. Okay. Okay, I want to show you a couple things here real quick. For one, if you notice, when I cut down my heel down here at the bottom, couple things. One, kind of cut your heels in towards the bottom, and that kind of gives it a realistic look as well. And then when you do your arch, you can kind of leave the heel out just a little bit on the arch, and then come down to it, and that gives it that curved look on the arch. So that's where you're looking for on the bottom. When you carve your heel off on the blank, it sticks way out right here. Okay, well, you're going to carve that off, but leave just a little bit, if nothing else, leave a little bit right there so you can tell where the heel actually is, and that'll give you a little bit of a guideline when you're drawing out your sole and your heel. So there, and then I told you I was gonna tell you what you can do down here at where it gets really rough. I've got a deep U-gouge right here, and this is what I use when I get down in here where it's kind of rough, because I can kind of roll it with the grains to this side and then to this side. Plus it gives it that curved in look on the bottom of the boot, okay? And then you can go back and just kind of clean that up lightly with your knife. Even you can just go right around the sides of it too. And we'll use this tool on a few different areas, okay? And then you can just go back with your knife and just kind of clean them little bumps up and get that little bit of a fuzz off of there that you're gonna get. It's just gonna happen, you know? So you can use that, or you can just leave the little facets in there if you want. This just kind of makes it look like it's, you know, got some folds in it and some wrinkles in it. So there, and another thing is when you cut your tip off right here, looking at this again, when we talked about this tip right here, if I decide to have a curved up toe, which is a really good big curve right there once I cut all that off, all right, don't chunk at it this way, because you're going to just take big chips at it. I mean, if you want to get it started and going down, you can start taking some of the big ones off. But once you start wanting to make the curve up, go away from the end. Anytime you got small ends, it's always good to just go away from that end if the grain's cutting nice, and you'll get a nice, better finish than a chipped up looking piece. All right, so, and you can work, you know, you can work that arch in the boot a little bit better. If you decide to have a lower boot, cut this off, same thing. When you get down in here, when you get to the tip, because once you start coming across here and coming in here, it's really going to start chucking off on you, so be careful. Just do that part slow and work it from away from the tip, and you'll be fine. Okay, that was one of the other things I learned from doing these. The other thing is up here at the top, same thing. Once you got it all bored out in there, you know, just be careful as you get close and you're working your way around these tabs. Just be careful because they will chunk off of there. And when you can, always carve away from the tip. That'll always help you with smaller things. So just work that to get it to where as thick as you want on the inside. Especially if you're going to put like the toothpicks in it. You know, if you want to put the toothpicks in it, you can see I kind of rolled this out to the outside and hollowed it out a little bit. Okay, it just makes it easier to get them in there, and it also makes it lets them spread out, fan out a little bit in the holder. So just kind of more of an attraction look to it. But up here, just keep taking this down, and remember, you're going to do a little bit here on the inside too, so don't take it too far yet. All right, up here at the top where you got the little V, to put the little V cut in there, get it almost to where you want it and almost done, and then you're just going to cut down and in. I'm sorry, I'm kind of hard to do this in front of the camera, but make that as much as you want as well. You know, don't be afraid to make it stand out a little bit, especially on a bigger boot, and just chip that out of there like so. And you can do that on both sides if you want. Put you a mark in the center if you want, and draw it in there. Put a little V there if you want to get it exactly. These things are really critical when you're working with the little boots. But basically just make you a V-cut down in there. See, this one's going to be a little harder end of the grain. So work that out. Get that to where you like it. And really you're just going for the effect, the look of it. Just be careful when you start chucking around at the top, because the tip will break off on you. Okay? Get that down there. It won't come out of there. There it goes. Just like so. Okay. Now let's do some details. So I told you I did this one earlier. Just so you could remember. And I could remember what some of the things I did to it. So, put your little tab in. Both sides. Just try to get them looking the same. This one looks a little fatter. but we'll just come in a little bit when we cut it. Okay, and if on the tabs too, you can also round these off if you want. Like on most boots, they're rounded. I think I did that on this one, sort of. Just take the corners off and give it that little bit of a roundness to it. Got your lines in there. Go to your heel now. Put your heel line in. Come across. And I'm kind of doing this quick so we don't have a big long video, but you can get the general idea of what to do. Okay, so I get my heel in there. Next, I'm going to do my sole. So I'm going to come in. And a couple different ways you can do this. You can just come down from here, or you can cut it right across here. Just depends on the look that you want to create. Okay, you can have a big thick sole. Or a thin, close sole. Okay, measure it off right there. Come over here. Put your little mark so you know exactly what you're working with. And I just really kind of try to follow the contour of the bottom that I got. Then I might just roll it up into there. And just kind of keep it the same. And make it meet over here. Okay. The other things you can do to it is you can put the arch, because all these boots are, usually when they're made in pieces. So you just think about how a boot's made and you can pretty much figure out where you want to put your lines. If a boot was sewed together like that, this would be a piece, and then we got two pieces here. So we got to do these down here, run that down the middle, try to meet your heel. You can have some curve to it, gives it kind of a look of motion. Just play around with what you like. Then you got the back piece here that's usually sewed on. And like I said, boots are all different. There's a lot of different designs out there that you can do on your boots. Just depends on how far you want to take it. Okay, so we got those drawn in. Sometimes you'll see the little flap part up here that'll come around here and come up to a point right here. Sometimes you'll see a piece that comes down this way. Okay, it's just decorative things you can do to it. And then I like to take and leave a little rim for the seam, the kind of reinforcement at the top of the boots. And I'll do something like this and just put a little seam around it. Try to keep it about the same. I come over here by my V, draw a line down. Follow it back into to there. That one's a little lower. Let's make this tab longer. This kind of short anyway. I think it stands out more when you got a little bit of a longer tab right there. Let's see what we did here. Down to about right there. Down to about right there. Just eyeball it in. Remember, it's caricature, so it doesn't have to be totally correct. You can play around, make it what you want. Just make sure you like everything before you start cutting it out. Alright, then you want your tabs to have a little curve to them too, so that way you can make them stand up. Alright, so, and I usually take my V tool. You can do a use a small V. Let's see what I got. Or you can just use your knife and just cut them in. I just like to use this because it's a little quicker. Just to get me started. Give me my lines. Just remember, if you don't cut it real deep right at first, you know, just get it kind of laid out. You can always go back and whittle it off if you don't like it. But if you cut it real deep, when you're laying it out, then at first you might have to go back and really take a lot off. So then I just continue to follow this all the way. And I'll do all my lines, okay? Following it around here to the tip. Just show you the kind of the tip. Just be careful right here and make it roll around and follow the tip. Like I said, this is caricature, so if it's really exaggerated, it just always kind of makes it look a little better. Maybe it's not a perfect line. That's okay. Adds movement, motion to my boot. Okay. Then once you like everything, you can go back and make your areas stand out. Right here across this top. I'm not going to cut these real deep because I'm probably going to go back and work on this one a little bit more just to get my final shape, but I wanted to give you the idea of how we go about putting them in. So, like, we got this one already somewhat done. It's not completed, but it's got some different things in it. These are just wrinkles. Back here, you'll notice I got the curve cut in a little bit. That's just a matter of put a big stop cut in all the way across where you want it, and then just go back in and just smooth that out and bleed them in together. Okay, these little wrinkles here, they're just stop cuts. Put your stop cut in. And then make a V cut out of it. Leave the little divots in there and look like wrinkles. Okay, so you can see this one, I've got it already cut out pretty good. I got a big long V in here. I got double heel down here. You can do a little double heel. Sole's all trimmed out. All right, just take your knife once you got it trimmed out and just kind of cut down into the I was trying to give you an area that wasn't totally completed yet. Down in there, just add a little more depth to that stop cut down in there. Just be careful because the heels and soles will chip off on you pretty easy if you're going in really hard. Okay? So just develop that out. The stitching. Okay, I use this little tool. I have a little file set here that came with our wood burner, and it's got a little round file with a point on it. So just go along all your marks. And just go all the way around and put in all your stitching. And this will take you a minute. If you want bigger stitches, you know, find you like an ice pick or something. And then the more you push it down in there and twist it, the better you can get your little stitches to show up. And then once you paint it, put your finish on it, they'll look really good. So what I try to do is, like, everywhere I put a stitch, I'll try to put the next one in between those two. Then that way it actually looks like stitching. I was getting a little close on this one. I should have went a little further away, but basically I just want to give you the idea of what to do. So you're going to go all the way up. Don't have to be perfect. Because once it's all done, it still looks good. Go all the way around everything. if you want. You know, that's just another way of adding that little bit of more detail to it. If you want more wrinkles in the back, if you want it really look wrinkled, do a bunch of these that are smaller, okay? Don't do them as big, and do a smaller one, smaller one, smaller one, and make it start out wide, and then get smaller as you go down towards the heel. Because the heel is the most, probably the most sturdy part of your boot, so it's not going to wrinkle as much on that, where it's kind of double sewed. But it might wrinkle, a worn out boot might wrinkle all the way down to the heel, or the I don't know what you call that, the heel support. So yeah, that's it. I mean, that's pretty much it, guys. We'll put a finish on this, get it all done, and we can do linseed oil. This is just a boiled linseed oil rubbed in. Okay, we didn't want to, because we were putting toothpicks in it. I didn't put any oil down in the inside bottom of it where the toothpick was going to sit. But this is just boiled linseed oil. And do some smaller ones. Work on smaller ones if you want. And you can practice your detail work, come up with different designs, things like that. So when you actually do a cowboy, you can put all the extra trimmings on his boots. Okay. Here's one I didn't show you. This is another way of putting a little detail on him. On your boot is to take and make a stop cut. And then come in to the side and just take a little sliver out of there. Just like so. And you can squiggle it around. It's another way you can put more details on there. You can draw your details on. And then just follow your line. And then come back in, tilt your knife, and just take a little sliver out of there. Just follow that around. It'd be kind of hard to see on camera, probably, but something like so. Once you get a few of them on there, it'll really start looking good, and it'll really add to the detail look of your carving. Okay. All right, guys. Well, once again, thanks for subscribing, and hope you have fun doing your cowboy boots. For me, this was a lot of fun, you know, just taking these little guys here and turning them into something like this. You know, it's a lot of fun practice. And once you get all the little stitching in here, because if you can do one of these, you can do one of these. You just have to work in smaller detail. Okay. All right, guys. Well, thanks for subscribing. Hope you enjoyed the video, and got some more stuff coming up soon. So stay tuned and make sure you subscribe and give us a like and a share if you got friends in the carving community. We appreciate it. All right. Thanks, guys.